Hi sis, what's up, what's poppin'? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new, I'm Mercedes, and in today's video, we are going to be talking about how many bundles you need to start your hair company. But before we start, I have to say, it has been brought to my attention that we have guys on the channel. So guys, welcome, welcome, welcome. Ladies, let's welcome the guys. Welcome y'all. I'm sorry if y'all ever feel like I was saying you couldn't win because I only say sis, this, this, that. But sis is just a habit for me. I've been calling people this for years. Back when women started calling each other bitch, bitch, bitch. Like, that was never my thing. I was like, sis, sis, sis. Because we don't need to be walking around trying to, you know, identify as bitches, okay? Like, we need to be sis women, you know. Bag holders, queens, whatever you want to call it. Not to get too... Yeah, I really be cracking myself up. Sometimes I be seeing what y'all be talking about. For the most part, I don't feel like I'm funny, but sometimes I really just tickle my own soul. So, anyway, I'm rambling. Let's go ahead and hop right into this video because y'all know I hate long videos. So, without further ado, boom, here we go. Bundles do you need to start your hair business? Okay, y'all ready for my answer? You ready? You ready? You ready? You ready? All right, you need 1,000 bundles to be successful. Now, I'm just bullshit. I'm just playing. I'm just playing. I'm just playing. Don't listen to that. Do not listen to that. No, no, no. You do not need a lot of inventory to begin in the beginning. Okay, did you hear me, sis? You do not need a lot of inventory. Now, I'm not one of those people that feel like you should start a business with strictly pre-orders, because you do want to have a little bit of hair on hand just so you can get anybody who is like in arm's reach of you, if that makes any sense. So you have to understand that people's loyalty, for the most part, lies to themselves. So if they want to support you, they may really, really want to have your back, sis. And y'all, they might really want to have your back. But if they really need their hair done, they're going to have to go get it from somebody else who has it on hand. So you don't want to plan this big launch and do this and do that, and then boom, you don't have any sales because some people just really need their hair today. So that gets me into my first suggestion with how many bundles I feel like you should start off with. I suggest starting off with enough hair for 3 customers. Yes, you heard me. 3 customers. That way you're not breaking the bank, but you're doing something to where you can get 3 people. Now, for the most part, most girls order 3 bundles. Well, you have guys too. So most of your customers will order 3 bundles and a closure, 3 bundles and a frontal, or you have some people that order 4 bundles and a closure, and rarely do people order 4 bundles and a frontal unless they're doing super long lengths. I don't suggest starting with super long lengths when you're first starting out. Not only is it more expensive, but most people do not get super long lengths like you think they do. Like, I sell 26 through 30, but the majority of my customers, they get anywhere between 16 and 24 for me anyway. I'm not sure what your demographic will order. You know, I'm not sure who you're targeting. For the most part, the average lengths of the bundles that I purchased in my business are 16 inches to 24 inches. So that being said, I suggest starting with 9 bundles, 3 closures, and 3 frontals. If you're tight on money, try your best to start with 9 bundles and 3 closures. Reason being is because most people are still doing closures. Frontals are more maintenance, which means more money, which means they have to be replaced more frequently. And your customers do know these things. So a lot of them will opt for a closure before a frontal. You know what I'm saying? And then if they be like, oh my God, do you have any frontals? You just try to tell them, no, I don't, but I do have closures, and closures are really good, and tell them the benefits of the closure. That way you can try to sell that product, because at the end of the day, we need that sale. You know, if they're inquiring, that's good, because that's the first step to purchasing something, inquiries, okay? So for my ladies who want to also sell wigs, something that you can do is, wigs do, you know, get expensive. So if you can't make your own wigs, And you can't afford wigs, introduce wigs later. Remember, we're going to grow as we go. We're not comparing ourselves to everybody else. Like, we have to learn that you cannot compare yourself to someone who's been in business way longer than you. It's only right that they're going to be way further than you because they started before you, you know, especially if you're not in a position where you don't have, you know, a lot of support, or if you don't have any, you know, money to promote or things like that. You have to understand that it is okay to start with something. You want to start with something, because if you don't, if you keep saying, oh no, I'm gonna just wait till I can afford this, I'm gonna wait till I can afford that, wait till, okay, sis, as far as I'm concerned, we live this life right here that we in right now. So I'm gonna need you to stop acting like we get another life. Like, cut it out. Go ahead and start the business without trying to make everything perfect. I talked about that in another one of my videos. So if you didn't see it, go see it, get your little motivation, because, you know, people told me it was motivational. So, you know, just go listen to it, but everything is not gonna be perfect. Okay, and I also, you know, once again, I know some people do have more money to start, which is perfectly fine. If you do introduce wigs at the same time, I would say three wigs in three different textures. So, and the same thing with your three girls that you're doing, I would say get those in three different textures. For the most part, I'm pretty sure everybody will agree with me on this one, most popular textures are straight and body wave. Straight and body wave are very, very popular. In my opinion, your third pattern that you should have is either deep wave or curly. Start with one of those, and again, sis, build your way, work your way to the top. It is a process. You gotta do. It ain't just, you gotta work your way, you know? You have to work your way up. Don't rush. Don't feel bad because you saw so-and-so on social media having 1,000 wigs, you know, or you saw so-and-so having 10 wigs and you only got one. You cannot do that. Remember, when you compare yourself, you're gonna hurt your feelings. Stop doing it. Okay, so again, you want to start with straight, body wave, and deep wave or curly. In my opinion, again, it's my opinion, you can start with whatever textures you like, but I'm telling you from experience, for the most part, I sell the most, absolutely, hands down, straight, body wave, deep wave, curly. That's what I sell the most of. So, for example, if you wanted to start out with, you know, your straight hair, you might want to do a 20-22-24 and a 18 inch closure. That would be one customer. Then you may want to do a 18-20-22 deep wave, you know, with a 16 inch closure. So most customers, they either get the same length closure of their first bundle, or they go down 2 inches to kind of create a layered effect. If they order a 20 inch closure and all you have is an 18, it's very easy to just ask your customer, is it okay if you take an 18 inch closure? For the most part, they're gonna say yes. So I would suggest, since you're starting out and, you know, we're not trying to break the bank because we are just starting out, go ahead and start with closures that are 2 inches shorter than your first bundle. So if you start with 16, 18, 20 body wave, get a 14 inch closure. If you do 20, 22, 24 deep wave, get a 18 inch closure. And if you do 20, 22, 24 straight, do a 18 inch closure. I hope you're keeping up with me, sis. I know it might sound a little difficult. Do not let it scare you. There, just rewind the video. You can watch it as many times. Never feel, you know, like you don't know anything, or never feel bad. Never feel stupid. Absolutely never feel stupid about feeling like you need to go back to comprehend something. Never do that. Always just go back. Don't worry about what nobody say. Watch your videos in peace. Learn in peace, and just, okay, it's okay, rewind the video, sis, if you need to hear it again. Okay, now again, if you have a little bit more money to invest, I would suggest starting with two bundles of each length from 16 to 26 of the three textures that we talked about. So body wave, straight, deep wave, or curly. I would suggest starting out with two of each. So 216, 218, 220, 222s, 224s, 226. Because the more hair that you do have on hand, the more likely you are to capture a sale. And that's the goal. However, even if you got it going on, sis, you balling, you or y'all, you know, you might got your money all the way there. I still don't want you to break the bank. With wholesale, I know a lot of girls will literally come to me and they will ask me, you know, I want to go ahead and order 50 bundles. I want to order 100 bundles. And I'm just like, slow down. You know, like I don't suggest that. Don't do it. Don't do it. Of course it's gonna make me more money. Of course I will be so happy if you ordered 100 bundles. But I just feel like honesty is truly the best policy, especially with keeping your business around for a long time. You just want to be honest to your customers, to your people that you're doing business with. And also, I'm not trying to have nobody spend $2,000, $3,000 with me and then they just feel like a failure because they can't get their hair off. I don't need you feeling like a failure with me by your side, sis. So it's just a no for me. So I don't suggest starting with that many. If you do, go ahead. But I don't suggest it. So if you value my opinion, please just try to start with a little bit less hair and see how that goes. And then if you feel like you knocked it out the park, sis, bump it up a little bit more. And if you knock it out the park again, you might just slide on in the home base, okay? Go ahead, sis. Get your 100 bundles. But try to build yourself up to 100 bundles. Don't just get 100 bundles. Okay, and another thing, if you don't have absolutely any money, I'm never saying that you can't do anything with pre-orders. I'm just being honest with you when I'm saying that with all this competition out here, don't let that phrase scare you. Please do not let that phrase scare you. Just listen to what I'm saying. With all this competition out here, you do have to understand that if you don't have hair and she has hair, somebody gonna go to her because they need their hair right then and there. So it is good, like I said, start with a little bit on hand. But if you can't start with absolutely anything, and let's just say you launched online where you weren't doing any like pickups in your city or anything like that, and you launch online, okay, that's fine. Then just do your pre-orders. But you do eventually want to work your way up to having some hair on hand. Pre-orders, I'm never going to be the one to tell you that you can't do it. I honestly feel like if people tell you pre-orders don't work, then they're lying, and you might want to just, you know, take their advice with a grain of salt, because pre-orders definitely work. So you never 100% know what you're gonna sell. Like, Black Friday is coming up. I don't know what I'm gonna sell. I am gonna drop a bag on Black Friday because I got an idea of what's gonna sell based off my sale. However, I'm not gonna buy 250 wigs. I might buy 100 wigs. You get what I'm saying? And then if I need more, then I will be like, okay, you know, I'll call my supplier, be like, okay, look, this is what I need. I need this. I need it done as fast as I can, such and such. So do not break the bank. Do not compare yourself to other people. And yes, it's like, that's how many bundles I suggest you start off with. I feel like 3 customers, and something else you need to understand, anybody that was watching this video and you feel like, oh, just 3 customers, that's all, let me tell you, some people cannot have 1 customer. And I'm not talking down on you if you haven't had your first customer yet, sis, but some people have not sold not 1 bundle of hair. So for you to sell 9 bundles and 3 closures, you are doing a great job. It is not going to happen overnight. Please don't think it's gonna happen overnight. Don't feel bad for only selling a small amount of hair, because the fact that you sold anything is an accomplishment, and don't let anyone tell you differently. Okay, so I haven't forgotten about my coaching thing. I'm definitely still just trying to make sure I teach what I feel like everybody needs to know. I'm reading the comments, I'm reading, checking, and responding to DMs that I can get to, because it is a lot. And I'm just trying to make sure I have everything down that I want to talk about and that I want to go over with the coaching, because I don't believe in taking people money if I'm not properly prepared for something. Do you get what I'm saying? I hope you do, and I hope you understand. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video. I really appreciate you all so much. I did a bougie on a budget. You know, I know some of y'all saw it, but hopefully, you know, I'm going to be switching up my channel. I want to, you know, be doing more things. Like, I'm going to keep doing the hair educational videos, but I'm also going to do bougie on a budget. I'm going to do hauls, like when I go shopping and stuff like that, because I just want to be more open on YouTube. I'm going to do girl talks because, you know, y'all like talking to me. You know, y'all like talking to me, and I feel like that's good. And then everybody doesn't have someone that they can talk to. So I want people to feel like, okay, this is a no judgment zone, and we are going to just you know, we're gonna have a good time on this channel, okay? Okay, so thank you again for watching. Bye, sis. Bye, y'all. And I will talk to y'all on my next video. Oh, don't forget to follow me on Instagram at okay, so that's her. What else? I think that pretty much covers this video. Yep. Trying to make sure I didn't forget anything. Nah, I didn't forget nothing. Bye, y'all.